hurry up. Here comes Po-Face and the governor.
Come over here quickly. You can take the rest of it.
What do I do with it?
Put it in your sock. Quickly.
Shit.
Quinn. Come on, you two. I want you to do a job for me in the library.
The library? Oh, good. I hate books.
Working in the library? It's a pretty cushy job for punishment, isn't it?
You know me, Smith. An old softy. Go on, move.
Maybe.
Well, well, well. So this is it. Finally got the nerve, eh? Get lost.
B?
Get out.
Right. Oh, Miss Ferguson. Oh, I got
Then go, Quinn.
Yeah, but...
Move it. Who goes first?
Now, don't be impatient, Mackenzie. I've got all the time in the world. You haven't.
What's wrong? You got the time and the place, but you ran out of guts.
Ferguson's prowling around outside that door, just waiting for us to lay into each other. Whoever's left standing will go up for it.
She's really got you scared, hasn't she?
Oh, yeah. Scared to death. I'll get you, Mackenzie. Just count on it. But not until I organise the time and place. I'm buggered if I'm going to do extra time just to satisfy Ferguson.
Do you know what I think, Smith? I think you've left it too late. You've run out of steam.
All that's left is hot air.
You just keep thinking that.
Hello, Lizzie.
Good day, love. You haven't seen Bea anywhere, have you? I've been worried sick.
What do you think I'm doing here?
Well, what are you talking about?
Well, Bea was sent to the library to help out, and then she and Nola told me to get lost. I reckon it's on.
God, I hope Bea doesn't do anything stupid. I know how upset she was about Patty, but killing Nola's not going to bring her back.
Well, Nola's not going to be any pushover.
Oh, come off it, Faye. Bea could take Nola on with one hand tied behind her back. I just don't want to see her in any more trouble.
Yeah, and you know what? The freak's patrolling the corridor outside.
The freak? God, she set it up.
Can we help you, Miss Ferguson? Maybe you'd like to take out a book?
Here's one for you. Leathercraft for the enthusiast.
What's going on? Quinn seemed rather eager to get out of here.
Oh, well, you know, two's company, three's a crowd.
She didn't quite fit in.
You don't look too well, Miss Ferguson.
Just get on with the books.
Yes, Miss Ferguson. Now, what was it we were up to, Nola? Hobbies, wasn't it?
A bit small and run down here now, but you've got to use your imagination. You know, a couple of coats of paint, a bit of wallpaper, take a wall out here and there, and you won't recognise the place.
Mr. Black, this place is no different to any of the others we've looked at.
Well, for the price range,
it's... Oh, come on, Harry, it's a dump. There's damp in the walls, the guttering's all leaking along the back, and I wouldn't be surprised if those bearer things needed replacing all along the side there.
Ellen, do you think I'd sell your friend a bad one? All of the places that we've seen today have got possibilities. You've got to trust me. You're very good in your business, and I know mine.
Well, I just wonder how you'd react if I palmed you off with an 85-year-old hooker who had sagging foundations and borers in a wooden leg.
Come on.
Well, I tell you what, you better come up with something a lot better than what you've shown us today, or that's exactly what you get.
All right, I'll tell you what. There's another couple I can show you tomorrow. They're not even officially on the market yet. But as a special favour, I'll let you in on them early.
Well, Mr. Black, I don't want to appear ungrateful, but I don't feel like traipsing all around the country while you try and farm something off on me.
Okay. At least now I know what you don't like. Let's make a time for tomorrow, and I think I can come up with something.
It's your last chance, Harry. You show us a turkey tomorrow, so you get a dog on Friday night.
You got a delicate turn of phrase, girl.
I tell you what, with the money he wants to pay, it's a surprise that he didn't jump at the 85-year-old hooker.
How'd it go in the library?
All finished.
Are you okay?
Yeah. Why shouldn't I be?
Oh, well, I just wondered. You and Bea looked like you was going to tear each other to pieces.
Oh?
Is Bea all right?
Depends on your viewpoint. You'd better start getting busy. Everybody's out of cigarettes and they're in big demand. You got plenty of papers?
Yeah, got a stack of them.
Well, get those fingers rolling. There's plenty of dough to be made.
Right.
And I've got nothing to do with this deal, remember?
Oh, yeah, right. Boy, at 50 cents a fag, I'm going to make a packet.
We're going to make a packet. And don't you forget it.
Well, Bea's got to do something soon. Everyone's starting to think she's backing down and Mackenzie's got her scared.
Don't be stupid. Bea knows what she's doing. Besides, I don't reckon that Bea should be the only one to stick her neck out.
Yeah, well, it was her idea. We all wanted to do it, but she wouldn't let us, remember?
Yeah, I know, but maybe she thought it was the top dog's job. Anyway, there's more to it than that. She was very fond of Patty.
Yeah. Then why is Mackenzie still walking around?
Oh, button up your mouth, Babs. Bea knows what she's doing.
Well, I reckon she's waited too long. Mackenzie's starting to look too strong for her.
Hurry it up, ladies. Come on, there are others waiting.
See what I mean? Now, I still owe Mackenzie for the bashing she gave me, and Bea better not think that I'm going to hang around forever to get
Bea even. Bea thinks that you better forget it. Mackenzie is no ordinary bash artist. She'll make mincemeat of you.
Yeah, but someone's got to do something.
I warned you before, Maxine. Now, just be patient and all will be revealed.
Yeah? When? Hey, listen. I've got some fags for sale if anybody's interested.
Yeah? How much?
50 cents a piece, or I'll trade you if you like.
50 cents? That's blooming highway robbery.
Depends on how badly you need them.
Hey, hang on. How did you get your hands on fags?
I'm growing my own.
Don't get smart with me,
God,
Quinn.
Right, you lot, hurry it up. Daniels, you want in the governor's office. Come on, move it.
Hey, what's she doing in so early?
Oh, I don't know, Daniels. Maybe she came in especially to see you.
Yeah, but I've done nothing
wrong.
Oh,
come on, get in.
Hey. Hi, Daniels. Thank you, Miss Ferguson. You can wait outside. Now, Daniels, as you can see, I have the buy-up orders in front of me. What I do with them is entirely up to you. I am prepared to let them go through in return for your assistance.
You're asking me to lag.
All I am asking is that you name the person or persons responsible for your accident on the stairs.
Yeah, well, it was, as you say, Mrs. D, an accident. Must have been my fault.
I don't think it was. All I want to do is punish the person responsible instead of taking away your buy-up privileges. Surely the entire prison shouldn't have to suffer to protect someone like that.
It was an accident.
Very well. If you women persist in this sort of behaviour, conditions will never improve. Miss Ferguson will take you back.
Okay, ladies, place your orders. Who wants to buy some cigarettes?
I do, but not at that price.
Well, the demand's very big and it's getting bigger from the look of the orders I'm taking, so if I were you, I'd buy now before inflation sets in.
Rack off, Faye. I don't know about the others, but I'm giving up until the next buy-up starts.
Me too.
God, why did I say that?
Suit yourselves. I'll be around when you change your mind.
What you want, love?
She tried to blackmail me into telling her who bashed me up. She reckoned she'd let the buy-up come in if I lagged.
And did you?
Oh, what do you think? Although I can't say I wasn't tempted. I tell you, Bea, it's getting harder. And if you don't do something about Mackenzie soon,
I will.
Don't you think you better go and get your breakfast? The work bell is about to go.
Yeah, well, this is more like it. Now, how come you didn't tell me about this place yesterday?
I told you, it's not officially on the market yet.
But it is available.
At the right price, but it's a bit higher than you wanted to go.
How much higher?
$110,000. But you can see the values. Good area, excellent condition.
Harry, you remember Gracie?
Who can forget her?
Well, Gracie was always a little out of your price range, right? And we're a bit in the same situation, so maybe we could make a deal. What's the lowest you reckon the owners will take?
Now, Helen, you know I'm only a one-man show. I've got to make a living too.
So you got less overheads. How much?
$100,000.
Remember Gracie. Legs up to here.
What about 85?
95?
I'd buy it at 90.
Done. And how soon do you expect your money to come through?
Well, any day now. It's already been approved. All I got to do is sign the check.
Well, in that case, I'll go ahead and have the papers drawn up.
Looks as though we're creating a bit of interest. Hi there. I'm going to be your new neighbor. I'm a Judy Brown. Well, what's your name? So much for my irresistible charm.
I'm only selling you the house, not the neighbours. You want sociable neighbours? Oh, it's going to cost you double.
No, thanks.
Right, that's $3. It's $1.50 well spent. Next.
Yeah. What are they for?
Right.
Any discount for cash?
Sure. You can have them for $2.
Thanks very much.
She's doing a roaring trade. How come you're not hopping in for your chop?
It's the principle. One thing I can't stand is someone taking advantage of someone's suffering. Besides, I'm broke.
Will you take a look at the size of these things? 50 cents for something like that.
Doesn't look well, does it?
It's not a fag, it's a fire hazard.
Here you go, Lizzie, you can have that one.
What? Oh, no, I couldn't, love. You had to pay too much for it. All right, I will. And that means you only owe me 9.
Yeah, well, there's only about 2 puffs in them anyway. You want one, B?
No, thanks, love. Thanks anyway, but no thanks.
I'll have 5.
Oh, right. 5. Any other takers? No? Well, I'm going back to my cell to stash the loot, so cover for me, will you?
That'll cost you $2.
What?
You heard me. $2. If you can take advantage of a situation, so can I. Where are you going, Mackenzie?
I'm going for the laundry, okay?
You can do that for free. There's your money back.
Why?
You tried to do the right thing by us, I'm just doing the right thing by you.
What are you doing, partner?
God, I nearly paid myself. I was going to give you your cut later on tonight.
I give you your cut, remember? And next time, do your dealings where Smith can't screw you for a take.
What else could I do?
Oh, forget it. I've got something else on my mind.
What? And can I afford it?
Quite a few of the women aren't buying.
Oh, they will when they save up their money. There's a lot of time before the next buy-up.
They got money. And suppose they lose their buy-up privileges again. They'll be loaded.
Then we'll make more cigarettes and make more money.
Oh, chicken feed. No, I've got something better in mind. What they need is an insurance scheme.
A what?
Insurance. You know, you buy a policy, and if something happens that you're insured against, you collect on it.
Huh. In this place, it sounds like a terrific way to lose a fortune.
Not if it's done right. Now sit down and listen. And make sure you listen to every detail, because as far as the other women are concerned, this is another one of your brilliant ideas.
an insurance policy. You must be out of your mind.
No, no, listen to me. See, if you take out a policy, I'll pay you $10 if you end up in solitary, $5 for any loss of privileges, like if you lose your buy-up or something like that, and $2 if you get stuck on cleaning duties for punishment, you know? And if you don't want to take it in cash, you can take it in cigarettes.
Yeah? And how much is this going to cost us?
Only $2 a week.
$2 a week? You must be off your rocker. If I'm going to pay out $2 a week, I want to see something for it.
Well, you will get something for it, insurance against punishment.
You know, there was one thing I couldn't stand on the outside, and that was pushy insurance salesmen. And I can't stand him on the inside, neither.
Well, at least think about it.
Right, we thought about it. Push off.
I don't know what's come over her lately. Next thing you know, she'll be flogging used toothbrushes.
Well, what do you think about that, eh? Me, a landlady. Oh, Helen, I can't thank you enough for everything you've done.
Oh, forget it. I had a ball.
Forget it? Are you kidding? If it hadn't been for Mr. Harry Black, I... Hey, you don't happen to be on friendly terms with a builder, do you?
Oh, well, if you ever need a Supreme Court judge, you know who to call.
Remember that one.
Oh, that's what I call service.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Davidson. How are you?
Fine. Hello, Helen. Mrs. Davidson, I was just leaving. I'll see you, Jude.
Okay, honey, and thanks again, eh? Mm-hmm.
Well, she was in a hurry.
Yeah, well, she's been with me all day. She's got to do a bit of shopping before she goes to work. She's been fantastic, you know that? She introduced me to a friend of hers. He was in real estate, you know, and we found this house. I mean, Mrs. Davidson, it's just perfect.
Well, that's marvelous. Was it a good price?
Yeah. In fact, there'll be some money left over for renovations and, you know, a bit of the bare necessities.
Well, it looks as if you're on a winning streak for a change. I came over to tell you about the careers officer's job. It's yours. I hope you're still interested.
Am I? What? Oh, wow, what a day, huh?
Well, I'd like to have a look at this house sometime, too.
Oh, sure. Well, after we've talked about the new job, I'll take you over, if you like.
I'd like that.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind seeing it again, just to make sure it's there. Oh, I can't believe it, you know? And I found the house that I want, the job that I want, all on the same day. Let's have a coffee to celebrate.
No champagne?
Are you kidding? What would the authorities say?
So, for $2 a week, you get insured against any kind of punishment. Now, what do you reckon?
Well, I don't know. What'd happen, say, if I paid up and then got transferred to Barnhurst?
Oh, the policy only covers you while you're in here.
So if I behaved myself and didn't have a claim, I'd end up down me dough.
That's the whole point of insurance policies. They don't protect you unless something goes wrong.
She does have a point, you know.
Well, I mean, what about what's happening now? Well, we're being punished for something we didn't do. I mean, somebody else did it, but we lost our buy-up.
And you reckon you pay out $5 in compensation?
For everybody out of policy, yeah.
You'd go broke in a week.
Well, that's the risk I take.
How many of the other women have joined?
There's quite a few thinking about it.
Well, I'll wait and think about it too.
Who dreamed up this little scheme?
I did.
Really? Doesn't sound like you. Much too involved.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm not a dill, you know. Are you interested?
You've got to be kidding.
Well, I must admit, I was surprised myself. The department doesn't usually move so fast, but it's happened. And now you're the careers officer. You looking forward to it?
You bet I am. I tried not to in case it didn't come off, but I liked the idea so much I couldn't help myself. Oh, sorry, there's a customer. Won't be a second.
Hello, Miss Bryant.
Mr. Erskine. And don't tell me you brought the check, right?
Well, yes, but...
Oh, well, it's okay. I'm not psychic. It's just everything is going right for me today.
Well, I thought you'd like it finalized as soon as possible. I got onto it straight away and I got the clearance this morning.
Well, thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
Now, if you'll just sign here and here.
Right.
And the release form.
You know something? This couldn't come at a better time. I've just been looking at buying a... There's a little mistake on here.
Where?
Well, you told me the amount was 100,000, right?
Yes, that's right.
Well, this says 69,000. I mean, I know there are legal fees, but this
But that $100,000 was gross.
Gross?
Yes, you see, apart from the fees and the conversion, there's the American estate tax. I'm sorry, Miss Bryant, but being an American, I naturally assumed you would know about that.
Well, I didn't.
Well, it's all set out here. The estate tax is the American equivalent of our death duties, and you know how much they can get to.
Yeah, but 69,000.
Well, it's still a considerable amount of money, Miss Bryant.
Well, I know that, but 69,000? I just bought a house for 90,000.
I know, hang on a tick. Listen, this insurance thing isn't gonna work. Nobody gives a stuff about it.
I'm not surprised the way you're going on.
What do you mean? I said everything you told me to say.
Oh, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. You need a different approach. You've got to be stronger with them.
Stronger? How do you mean?
Oh, listen, hell, do I have to spell everything out for you? You need a more forceful approach. Think about it, what would convince you to buy an insurance policy?
I don't know.
Oh, listen, you're supposed to be a partner. Do some of the thinking for a change, okay?
Oh, Judy, it's lovely. I can see why you were so excited. It would be ideal.
Well, I hope I can afford it.
Oh, you should get finance on the place. You have half the deposit and a second job. It shouldn't be too difficult.
I hope you're right. I'd hate to lose it after all this. I know one thing, though. All of my inheritance is going to have to go on it. There'll be no money left over for redecorating.
I've been thinking about that. I wonder if we could get a working bee from the prison.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Well, I don't see why we shouldn't try. So many will be reaping the benefit. Well, let's have a look around inside. You have the key?
I sure have. If Madam will just walk this way, I'll give you a grand tour after you. And this is going to be the living room.
It's a lovely size, quite bright too.
Yeah, oh, I hope I don't lose it now after all this.
Oh, stop worrying.
What the hell's that? Oh, hi. We met before, remember, Aunt Judy? Listen, how'd you get in here? Well, it's really nice to see you again, but I think it's time you ran along now, don't you?
Wow, that was a surprise. Who is he?
I don't know his name. I saw him when I was here before. I'll tell you one thing, he's shy.
And frightening.
Well, wouldn't you be if you ran into a couple of hefties like us?
I wonder how he got in.
I don't know. I must have left the door open. But let's have a look at the rest of the house.
Huh? Right here.
Ah, g'day, Faye.
Sign up any suckers at lunchtime?
No, that's why I want to talk to you.
Oh, come off it. I told you I wasn't interested.
That's not good enough. I think you ought to reconsider.
Hey? Oh, I told you I reckon it stinks. I don't want to know.
Hey! What's got into you? This isn't your style.
Sometimes when you have a difficult customer, you got to change your techniques. Now, you're going to buy a policy or not?
No way. You've got to be kidding.
I think you better before you have to buy an accident policy.
Ow! Well. Oh, all right, all right. Let me go. I'll join.
Okay.
Ah. There. I'm insured. Good. Talk about the mafia.
I knew you'd see reason when I explained the details to you.
I won't forget this, Faye.
I would if I were you.
What's up, love?
Flamin' Quinny. She got Mary and Jill to bail me up in the dunny, and then she forced me to buy on one of her insurance policies.
What? Heavy, Jack? Faye?
Well, I'm not talking about Tina Turner and the Pointer Sisters.
Oh, that's not her style. I know she's always been one for making a quick quid, but she's never used muscle.
Well, she did just now. You want to see the bruises?
I don't know. She's been weird all day. What are you going to do about it?
Oh, I'm thinking.
Going to tell B.
Huh. What good would that do me? By the time she did anything, I'd be a grey-haired little old lady.
Hey, we need another pickup from maternity. Mackenzie, you're it. Who says so?
Are you deaf? I said so.
Well, you'd better get somebody else. I got the last one.
You just don't understand, do you, Mackenzie? Big deal, boss lady.
That's right. It's about time you found out exactly what that means. And I think the best way to clear up your thinking is to have your head steam cleaned and pressed.
Back off! Mackenzie, what the hell do you think you're doing with that?
Just
Just exercising, Mrs. Powell. Well, this isn't a gym. All of you get back to work.
We'd love to, Mrs. Powell, but we need another pickup for maternity.
Well, it's simple, isn't it? Daniels, do it.
Why me?
Don't answer me back. You've been in enough trouble lately. Now move it. Okay, ladies. This is a warning. There's an officer on patrol in the corridors, and I'll be popping back later, just in case I need it.
That should go a long way towards solving the problem. Yes, I will. And you'll be in touch with her soon? Thank you, Myra. Bye-bye.
Oh, thanks for doing that, Mrs. Davidson. It really sounds promising.
Of course, she'll have to get the rest of the committee's approval, but it looks as though the PRG are willing to act as guarantor for $25,000. That should lend extra weight when you're applying for finance.
That's fantastic. Good old Myra, eh?
And as a bonus, they will also pay the rates, and the money from the department can pay off the mortgage.
I can't believe it. Thanks so much, Mrs. Davidson.
Judy, for goodness sake, stop saying thank you all the time. You're doing us the favour. It's your money.
Yeah, but it's something I really want to do.
Well, Myra will be in touch with you in the next couple of days. Now, I'd better start thinking about a working bee. How many would you need and what's to be done?
Oh, it's a bit early for that. I mean, settling won't be for a couple of months yet.
Yes, I realise that, but it'll give me time to sound out the women and decide who should go.
Well, I can think of a couple I'd like to have there.
Yes, I realise that, but I think you'd better leave it to me. It will depend largely on who's been behaving.
Ow!
What are you doing in this cell, Daniels? I sent you to the maternity section.
Ah, Mrs. Powell. My hands were dirty, so I just thought I'd pop in here and wash them.
Getting a bit fussy all of a sudden, aren't we?
Well, you never done a pickup from maternity.
Soap, give it to me.
Hey? Oh, it's just ordinary soap.
I said give it to me. Okay. Now that you're squeaky clean, why don't you go back to the laundry where you're supposed to be?
You know, I'm getting a bit sick and tired of being pushed around. You might be happy going around dirty, but I'm not.
Feeling a bit lucky all of a sudden, are we? Okay. On the way to the laundry, why don't we drop in at the governor's office?
Oh.
Get out.
Oh, gee.
Excuse me, Henry. And where have you been?
Governor's office. Mrs. Powell sprung me for being slack on the job and answering back to an officer.
And what did you cop?
Clean of duties.
Them's the risks.
Hey, wait a minute. Didn't you say you had to buy an insurance policy?
What?
Your insurance policy. You're insured against punishment.
Don't tell me you fell for that swindle.
No, I didn't fall. Anyway, Lizzie, you're right. I get paid for cop and cleaning duties.
You hear that? You owe me.
Daniels, you've already been in trouble. Now shut up.
Yeah, well, how much did you say it was?
$2. I'll get it for you when I get to my
cell. Ah, beauty! That means I get my investment back for this week.
This insurance lark doesn't sound a bad thing. Put me down for a policy, Faye. I'll be in it.
Okay. Yeah, is it?
Me too.
Oh, right. Well, there's room for everybody. I'll see you in the rec room.
Oh, cut it out.
Hey, come on, ladies, don't push. Everybody will get their chance. Hey, and keep the noise down, will you? We don't want the screws poking their nose in.
That's not a bad idea. I reckon the screws should take out insurance. What's the going rate for screw bashing?
Name?
Elizabeth Birdsworth.
Age?
39. Ancient. You know, I reckon I should be on a different rate from all the others because they can't put me in the pound because of me ticket. So I'll never be able to collect the big one. I reckon I should only give you $1 a week.
sorry, Lizzie. No special rates. Anyway, not being able to be put in the pound's a bonus. Where's your money?
Oh, all you insurance salesmen are the same.
I thought you was broke.
My broker made a big kill this morning on the market.
Nick.
Here's me money. I said I'd pay.
Right, Nabs, $2 for you.
Well, it was a nice try, Lizzie. Huh.
But look, Bea, she's doing all right. Nearly everyone's joining up.
Mary. So, Mackenzie, aren't you buying an insurance policy? Probably a good idea. You wouldn't be around long enough to collect.
I carry my own insurance.
Hey, come on, hurry up.
I want to see you outside.
Oh, but I've got all them.
Come on. They're not going anywhere. Okay. Who else is behind this insurance caper?
I don't know what you're talking about. There's only me.
Come off it. It's a good idea. Very clever, but too clever for you.
Oh, thanks very much. As it so happens, it was all my idea.
What does I hear about you heavying Maxine into a policy?
She just needed a bit of encouragement, that's all. Anyway, she's not complaining now it's paid off.
I don't like it, Faye. I don't like it one little bit.
Well, I'm sorry, but there's nothing we can do about it now. I mean, the girls aren't going to like it if you knock it in the head. Not now.
I'd tread very carefully if I were you, because I'm going to be keeping my eye on you.
Oh, Bea, you don't have to worry. It's all fair and square, honest.
It had better be.
Hey, will you get a load of this? Maxie copping cleaning duties was the best thing that could have happened. They all want to join up now. I'll tell you what, you was right about having Maxine into buying that policy. Best thing I could have done.
So that's what you did. That isn't exactly what I meant by using a stronger approach.
Well, I've seen it done around this joint so often, I thought it was worth a try.
You were lucky Smith and her gang weren't around at the same time. You would have been in big trouble.
I'm not stupid. I checked that out first.
You're not turning out to be such a bad pupil after all.
Yeah. At least I'm cheap. Is this all I get?
Don't be greedy.
But I do all the legwork.
And I do all the brain work.
So who thought up the idea of putting the heavies onto Maxie?
Oh, yeah, that was real bright. How much did the muscle cost you?
$1 a piece, $2.
So that means you spent $2 to sell a $2 policy, which cost us another $2 in compensation.
Yeah, well, at least it got the others to join up.
You were lucky this time. Well, well, well. Would you look at this?
Good. I could have got caught with that. Who do you reckon did it?
It's too subtle for Smith. What did you say Maxine was put on cleaning duties for?
Talking back to Po-Face and being slack on the job, I think. Why?
I think I'll just find out. Hello, Maxie.
What do you want?
Oh, a chat, a little bit of information.
Yeah? What about?
About why you were put on cleaning duties this afternoon.
Talking back to a screw, why?
Which screw?
Mrs. Powell.
And where were you when you were talking back to this screw?
In the corridor.
In the corridor. Are you sure? You didn't happen to be caught in somebody's dormitory by any chance?
No, of course not. I was on my way to maternity because you wouldn't go, remember?
That's right. But you had to go past my cell. You didn't happen to drop in and leave me a little present by any chance.
I don't know what you're talking about.
This.
Oh, no, nothing about it.
I think you do. You were clumsy again, Maxie, and you left the tap dripping.
No, I did not turn it right off.
There, I told you. Do you know what to do, Maxie? We're going to
clean your
face a nice little wash.
No, don't it, please.
Stop, Mackenzie.
Oh.
Come on! Oh, it's coming in here! It was really dumb, wasn't it? Lizzie, watch the door. Maxine, fill up the sink.
Can't do anything now, Bea. Well, we've missed in the dining room.
So, well, I'm not hungry anyway. Come on, Maxine.
Oh, thankful.
That's good.
you found out how Patty felt. You just kept pushing her head down until the bubbles were. Isn't that what you said?
Oh, you missed your chance, Smith. It's not your lucky day.
It's worth.
What are you lot doing in here? Didn't you hear the bell? We were just going, Mrs. Powell. Coming, B? Well, then get out.
Thanks, B.
Get going. All right, all right. It's only breakfast, not a banquet. Get out.
I can say that again.
Babs.
Get out.
You're in the workshop today, aren't
you?
I suppose so. That's what I was told yesterday. Good. There's a little article I want you to pick up for me.
Can you cover for me? I want to get something out of the kitchen.
What are you talking about? You're not supposed to be in there.
I know that. That's why I want you to cover for me. I don't want to get caught. Yet.
Well, what are you after?
Oh, just a few good goodies, bits and pieces.
Are you out of your cotton picking mind? You'll never get away with it.
Be funny if I did, though, wouldn't it?
Well, you know what they'll do to you if they catch you.
I'll be all right. I'm insured.
What's your insurance got?
Martin and Murray, workshop. Mackenzie, general cleaning. Daniels is under punishment and will clean the toilet and shower block.
Gee, thanks, Mrs. Peel.
My pleasure. Right, the rest of the laundry. Don't take all day getting there either.
Think you can manage that?
No worries.
Good.
Hey, where's Lizzie?
Don't know. I haven't seen her since brekkie. Why?
She's done it.
Done what?
You'll find out.
Well, what do you have to say for yourself?
Nothing. I did it. I got caught, and I'm ready to take me punishment.
Lizzie, you've been here long enough to know that stealing from the kitchen is a very serious offence, and it was such a blatant attempt. How did you expect to get away with it?
I was desperate. Since we lost our buy-ups, I was very short of a few things.
Tomato paste, pot scrubbers, oven cleaner. What on earth are you going to do with it all?
Sell it.
I'm sure there'll be a great demand for that sort of thing.
Well, what do you reckon it'd be worth?
I beg your pardon?
Me punishment.
Well, as you're so anxious, loss of remissions. Take away, Mrs.
At Mike. All.
What do you mean?
Well, couldn't you swing it for a couple of days in isolation?
Lizzie, are you having trouble with the other women? Is that what this is all about?
Me? Oh, I'm great mates with everyone.
Then why? Oh, loss of remissions. Thank you, Mrs. Morris.
Come along, Lizzie.
Mrs. Morris? Have you any idea what this is all about?
No, I haven't. But I agree with you. She's up to something.
Well, that'll be all.
You all right, Lizzie?
Yeah, terrific. Why?
I was just wondering.
As a matter of fact, Mrs. M, I do feel a bit queer. You know, sometimes I get this funny head just before I have one of me old troubles with me ticker.
Well, do you want to see a doctor?
Oh, no, it's not serious as that. Sometimes if I just have a bit of a lie down and come back as good as gold.
Perhaps you'd better go to your cell and lie down now.
Oh, yeah. Well, thanks, Mrs. M.
Okay, sort them out into three piles. One for whites, one for colours, another one for anything that's stained.
I know.
Hey, listen, what's all this about, Lizzie?
Well, she wanted to get caught pinching stuff from the kitchen.
What for?
So she'd get punished.
I think I know why, but tell me anyway.
So she can collect on her insurance.
So she's cottoned onto it, has she? I wonder how long it'll be before the rest of them will wake up.
Well, when they do, Faye'll be paying out a fortune.
Well, it just might teach the little money grubber a lesson, mightn't it?
Yeah.
Got some cleaning rags that need washing.
Anything else?
A little present for you. In the bottom of the box.
Any problems?
No.
Good girl, I remember this.
No worries.
Hey, Bea, I'm going to do another pickup.
Right.
corridor around the corner?
Yes, Mrs. Powell.
Well, it doesn't look like it. It'll have to be done again, won't it?
Yes, Mrs. Powell.
You're not here to exercise. The idea is to get them clean. And when you finish that one, I want the corridor outside the kitchen done.
Yes, Mrs. Powell.
Listen, I don't like the tone in your voice.
Yes, Mrs. Powell.
All right, get on with it. I'll be back to check later.
Feeling all right. Haven't you heard?
What?
I got caught nicking stuff out of the kitchen, and Mrs. Davidson really went to town on me.
You silly old thing, what'd you do that for?
Well, I couldn't help it, could I? I didn't try to get caught. I reckon I'm slowing down a bit. I ought to give it up in my old age. I thought I was as safe as a church when suddenly up pops Mrs. M and whammo, I get dragged off in front of Davo.
What'd you get?
Well, she tried to throw the book at me and I begged and pleaded because of my age, but she must have got out the wrong side of the bed or something because she was in a rotten mood.
What did you get?
Well, at first she wanted to throw me in the pound and chuck away the key. Thank God they've done away with hanging, that's all I can say. And then, of course, I broke down and cried, and that really got to her.
Yeah, I can imagine. So what did she give you?
Well, she couldn't chuck me in the pound, so she confined me to my cell, and I've lost my remissions.
Oh, gee, Lizzie, that's real tough. But look at it this way. I mean, you don't have to work. You're better off than the rest of us. I'll see you around.
Hey, Faye. I just remembered. I'm insured, aren't I? I completely forgot. What about me compensation?
You're not gonna claim for having a rest.
It's not a rest. It's a punishment. And I lost me remissions.
All right, I'll pay you for your loss of remissions. That's $5.
And for being confined in my cell?
I'm not going to pay you for that. You flatten your back.
That's got nothing to do with it. And don't know what the other women will say when they hear you're Welsh. They'll probably pull out of the scheme too.
Okay. But I'm not going to pay you the same rate as for solitary.
How much?
$3.
Five is half the going rate.
All right, five. That's eight altogether. I'll go and get it.
Hey, Faye. Five and five is 10, not 8.
Mackenzie, I am sick to death of telling you to clean these damn floors. What's wrong with you?
Oh, nothing. I just feel a bit grog.
Sudden, isn't it?
Yeah.
Do you need to see the sister?
All right. If I could just lie down for a bit.
Look, either you're sick and you're going to see the sister, or you get on with the job I've given you.
All right.
Make sure you do. I'll be back later, and you make sure they are clean.
Visit from your mate, B. Smith.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down, but the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare.